This is a special present. One time for old times. What do you say we play some football as we are underway from Oakland in the John Madden Legacy Game? Here comes Devin Hester. Bring it out. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So it's the NFC Stars who will get the ball first. And Charles, as we alluded to, we've got a different era of coach on each sideline. So the man coaching this NFC squad will... And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Back to throw here. This ball nearly intercepted. A once-in-a-season chance for the big fella, but he couldn't corral it. Fourth down, straight ahead. The Hall of Famer's kick is good, and the NFC on to an early 3-0 lead. Well, they started the drive back to pretty deep. A nice effort to overcome the field position, getting the field goal range on the game's opening possession.
And Brandon, I think from where they started, the initial thought was, can we get one or two first downs and help out our defense after we pump the ball away with field position? But as that drive went on, and the sights got set a little bit higher, they were thinking touchdown, ended up settling in between and coming away with a field goal.
So, Charles, as mentioned, we've got another Coach Madden over here on the AFC sideline. Of course, his Raiders, members of the AFC West. So this is a conference he battled in for his entire career. And you think about the landscape of the NFL as he was getting into the back half of his tenure. It was a golden era for coaches. You had Don Shula, Tom Landry, Chuck Knoll, Bud Grant. But it was John Madden who had the best winning percentage of them all, CD. 759, the best ever. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey, and he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. And they'll take possession already in the red zone and in a great spot to add points to the scoreboard.
And, Brandon, how many times have we seen a defense with a lot of field behind them get even more aggressive, right? They feel like they've got them not pinned down, but in a favorable spot for them. And they took advantage of it there, got a nice interception, and set up their offense in great shape.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Favre. Open man right side is cut, complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. He'll look to throw. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown, NFC. George Kittle from 8 yards out as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And the lead goes to 10-0. Scoring summary, 3-play drive. And it all ends with a George Kittle touchdown. So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. Here comes Hall. He's going to bring it out. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The offense for the AFC set to go now. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
A first carry for the Hall of Famer, Marcus Allen. And nowhere for him to go again. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. Throwing is Brady on third down. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the NFC will take over first and 10. The NFC heading back out. Hall of Famer Randy Moss a part of this offense. And Coach Madden, boy, he always appreciated the ferociousness with which number 84 attacked the football in the air.
As Randy Moss says, just chuck it up there, dog, and I'll go get it.
And, Coach, boy, did he ever go get it. Over 15,000 receiving yards, 156 touchdowns. And how about this from his rookie year of 1998?
And this will be caught at the 30. And all the way in for the touchdown. Calvin Johnson, 65 yards. And his guy's now an extra point away from taking a three-score lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. Well, sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. Hey, that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long, man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
So an early advantage now and a good one. 17-0 our scores. They kick this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25. The AFC offense heading back out. You know, Charles, Coach really loved to utilize his tight ends in the passing game. You think about Dave Casper, Hall of Famer for those great Raider teams. And I think he saw a lot of Dave Casper in an all-Madden staple, Tony Gonzalez.
Tony Gonzalez is the type of tight end I think everyone's looking for. He's a guy that can make some big plays from that tight end position. Let me tell you, you better make sure you have him accounted for on every play.
And that's exactly right, because Dave Casper, he could shred defenses down the middle of the field. And that's exactly what Tony Gonzalez did in his entire career, a 14-time Pro Bowl selection. And Tom Brady has more. There are six guys in the 15,000-yard receiving club. He's the only tight end in there. Tony Gonzalez, every snap, he had to know where he was because he could make plays short, medium, and long, and often put the ball in the end zone.
One quarter in the books at the Coliseum. What a day. The AFC with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up.
Cover, cover!
They'll try and pound it with a big back Bettis. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield.
Go Bandit!
Here's Allen. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Now Brady. This will be caught by Brown. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On the draw, here's Allen. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. They keep it on the ground. Allen again. And a short gain here down to the 22. They go with Chubb on second down. 2 minutes remain here, the first half of the John Madden Legacy Game. We'll be back. Hey, we want to let you know, give you a fair warning, that coming up at halftime, the folks at EA Sports have put together a very nice package in tribute to Coach Madden, so make sure you stick around for that. Again, coming up at halftime. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. On now is Vinatieri as he'll try the field goal. This from 44 yards out, left hash. The career leader in field goals made knocks that one through. And they're on the board at least here. It's now 17-3. So Charles, they're on the board after that kick. So three drives, 3 points. Obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that zero off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point of drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they've got three now. They hope that that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
Ready to begin their next drive here, the NFC offense. That swung out wide to Sanders. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of five. They're going to hurry back to the line now. On second down, Favre. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Now the AFC going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down.
That might be the third down stop that they needed because they've had a lot of trouble slowing down this offense in the first half. This might be their opportunity to get off the field.
And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety.
Every team has plays in their book to try and buy some room when a safety's on the table. But a big variable is how does each team deal with the pressure of executing in those situations? In this case, they didn't, and they gave up 2 points.
The AFC offense set to take their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now the AFC going to take a timeout. It's their second as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. On first and 10, here's Brady. Across the formation, he's got a man. That's Allen. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. From the 45 on second down, Brady, he's going to float this one deep right side. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there, you throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So that PI call will give them one more play.
And it'll be an untimed play as well. Now the half will end after this one, unless there's another defensive penalty.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. He connected on his first. This time it's 39 yards away. Anderson's kick is good, and that will do it for this.
But coming up in the second half, we'll run through John's post-coaching triumphs. But for now, we present a very special tribute to the man of the hour, narrated by Trey Mosley. The AFC going to get the football first here as we are back underway from Oakland in the John Madden Legacy game.
Well, now how about this return? He's to midfield. The 30. 10, 5, and he will score. Touchdown, AFC. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know who we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much as you try to get the score. Perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. Fields it right around the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. The offense for the NFC ready to get their next drive started. And their defense just helped them out by getting the football back on the opening drive here in the second half. And now can the offense follow through with point? Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Steve Atwater with a pick. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30.
but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down. They'll keep it on the ground. Allen. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. They haven't made much of this great starting field position they had. Here's third and six. They run the draw play. Allen. And this won't do it. He needed six. He only got halfway there. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. Defensive coach, when I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys in the picture going after the ball carrier.
So kind of disappointing there. I mean, yes, they get the three, but with starting field position like that, three's not what you're banking on.
No, and you just have to wonder if you can afford to let chances like that continue to pass you by. You've got to find ways to get the ball to the end zone and put sixes on the scoreboard.
Ready to begin their next drive here, the NFC offense. The last drive for this offense, Charles, you remember it ended in one play, that quick interception, but they do still have the lead as they start this drive here.
And that's something to focus on for them as well, because it's not quite no harm, no foul, but the interception, hey, shake it off, move on. Hasn't cost your team the lead, and now it's time to rebound, and the quarterback and his teammates, they can add to the lead with a good drive here.
And they're going to hurry back to the line now. On first down, Favre. That's down the field to Moss, complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10. As they've got things rolling on this drive. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Cameron Hayward getting upfield to make the stop. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Flush to his right. Open man downfield is Rice. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They'll go right back to the ground with Dickerson. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. Call it a gain of 2 as time has run out on this third quarter play. So through three quarters of the John Madden legacy game, it's the NFC Stars and young Coach Madden on top. And we'll be back to the Coliseum after this. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Inside give to Dickerson. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. And that's going to be caught. Touchdown NFC. Jerry Rice, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, gotta give him credit, found the perfect play call
Quarterback ready to call as soon as the target came through. And his guard made a nice catch. Just had a drop in practice and executed in the game.
Following the touchdown, here's Anderson to kick it away. And Hall not going to bring this one out. The offense for the AFC set to go now. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And he's going to bring this one back for an NFC touchdown.
Well, that's what you get, apparently, when you try to take on a Pro Bowl cornerback. And what a play there to make the interception and also bring it back for six.
And he is so good that we've seen teams absolutely stay away from throwing the ball at him. Here he's just ran the quarterback's eyes the entire way, makes a great play on the football, and turns it into six.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. No run back here for Brown. This will come out to the 25. The AFC offense set to take their next drive.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And, Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Toss play, Allen. And he'll get about three up close to the 35. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. Throwing now is Brady. And he'll find Hall. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. Call it a gain of six on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
So 2 minutes to play in the John Madden legacy game, and the NFC well in control. And we'll be back to Oakland after this.
Now Brady got to have this one. He is going to find Hill here.
Easy.
And he is going to be taken down, but a big gainer there on fourth, and the AFC going to keep the drive alive. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. Looking to throw again on second down. Brady. There's Hall bringing in another one. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two. To throw is Brady. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete, certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And I don't think he got there. He did not. They stop him a yard shy. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And this one is incomplete.
Let's go now.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And they go play action with Favre. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. And he hits Jason Witten, the tight end.
Well, this has certainly been special. And, Charles, as we wind down toward the end of this John Madden legacy game, your final thoughts?
Well, let's face it, partner. It's going to be hard to overestimate the impact that he made, not just on the sport of football, but on his family, friends, players, co-workers, and in the lives of millions of Americans who watched it. There will never be another John Madden.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Play number 7 now coming up on the drive. 3rd and 5. Play action. It's Favre. Man open. It's Moss complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. First and 10, it's Favre. Tries for Rice, intercepted. Picked up by 9-time Pro Bowler Ed Reed. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. So after the INT, it's Brady. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. On first down, Allen. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20. So it's a win here for the NFC. Just an incredible afternoon of football and remembering the life of John Madden. And before we go, one final message, and for all of us at EA Sports, this one's for you, Coach.
I just say this, I thank you all very much. This has been the sweetest.